You know, I feel that this is the first time I've come for India Film Project, and though I was always aware of it for so many years, how they started in Ahmedabad and then moved to Mumbai.
Yeah.
But the enormity with which they have now come in this year is something that is unbelievable. And I got so fascinated with how they are managing not only within India now, they're also doing internationally, and how they're focusing on content creation through such a mass participation. I find that fascinating. I also think that it somewhere legitimizes a small art form like wedding videos also.
Yeah.
Because earlier wedding videos did not have that standing. But today when you look at it, it's actually filmmakers making those videos. They are made with such great cinematic value. It's almost like a film. You know, the couple and the families and everything. So IFP, when I see them acknowledging even those videos, it's a lovely thing because you're embracing a new form. It's a new art form. You're embracing short films.
Yeah.
You're embracing, I think, web series also.
Right.
So it's fantastic. And I'm very happy to be here. I was participating in the talk, in an interview with Megha, the talk shop.
Talk shop.
With Megha, and I thought Megha was fabulous.
The conversation was really interesting.
Yeah.
In fact, you know, there it was, you raised like two very interesting points. One of them was like, you know, when you because you always experiment with subject, right?
Yeah, yeah.
But do you think that, you know, because so far, whatever you have delivered, it's mostly like larger than life,
right?
And
right.
People mostly appreciate that. Hmm. So when you think about experimenting on something, do you not look at the smaller subject or do you always look for a big canvas film? Like the canvas wise, you know what I'm trying to say, right?
Yeah,
like
yeah.
Most of, yeah.
Yeah. No, I'm not always looking for something to do on a big scale. You know, for me, it's the story. So if the story connects, then I don't mind going out and trying to make that as a film. So if you look at After Lagan, I made a Swades because that story interested me.
The canvas was again the cinematography, the canvas,
yeah,
the nature.
Yeah.
You include every single thing.
Yeah.
In a big canvas. All your films are big canvas films. That's why I was just trying to figure out that if you.
No, you're right.
Intentionally.
Someday I'd like to make a film which is, you know, shot in 45 days, one location,
in one
indie film, and. But the story has to inspire you. That story has to make me think, oh my God, I have to make this, you know.
Right.
So I'm a great lover of the independent cinema. I think there are so many stories that need to be told and are being told now.
Mm-hmm.
And so many biopics. I used to be fascinated with biopics and I never thought that India will sit up so much. When I'm saying India, I mean the entire audiences, because without the audience's support, we cannot make these biopics.
Sure.
So a lot of films are working, which are very differently made, the cinematic idiom is different.
Yeah, the treatment of the story. Definitely.
And now India Film Project is trying to take that movement a step ahead.
Right.
Which I think is great. So I really
appreciate
Ritam Bhatnagar.
Right.
Because he's single-handedly done it. I know how small he started. And I myself, I couldn't go to him twice in Ahmedabad. Twice or thrice, I don't know how many times he told me. And each year I was doing something or the other. So finally I'm here today.
Yeah, yeah. Sir, I have two more questions. One is that you were talking about biopic, right? If I ask you to choose two subject, two personality to do biopic on, who are they be? And another thing is that, sir, you were talking about, you know, telling a story in like short films you are talking about.
Yeah, yeah.
And you said that you love independent films, indie kind of guerrilla shooting style and all of that. None of your film looks like that, though.
Yeah, because I haven't done that.
Films.
No, I haven't done that. No.
But do you think telling a story in 3 hours is more challenging with songs and, you know, kind of creating more cinematic moment, or you know, telling a story, managing the same intensity within 5 to 10 minutes?
No, I think it's again, it's script driven. That question is more script and more related to budget.
Yes.
Because how you're going to blend the two, where your ambition is to tell the story, but also the business aspect of it.
Mm.
How are you going to tackle that? Because you can make a 1 crore film or a 2 crore film and still have no success. That means you've lost 2 crores.
Mm.
Or you might make a 100 crore film and it might just break even. So there is no predictability here for the form. So I have respect for even the small films, that small film that is made in a 1.5 crore and does 2 crores.
Yeah.
That's a 50 lakh plus. It's a great
like
jump.
50% jump.
Yeah, yeah. So I think it's about the script and related to budget.
Yeah, and the biopic, that my question was like, two personality, if I'll ask you to choose from, maybe one from history.
I think 20 years from now, I'll make one on Ritam Bhatnagar.
No. But that is like too realistic and too interesting. It's not even known for. But if I ask you, yeah.
Actually, good question. I haven't thought about anybody in particular to make a biopic on yet.
Your inspiration, your any filmmaker, any actor, any personality who inspired you to tell story?
I recently acquired a book called My Name is Gauhar Jaan by Vikram Sampath, who is the first lady to have recorded for the Gramophone Company of India. She's a great singer of a forgotten era. So I think that's a lovely book. And that's an inspiring book.